Hello dear friends, welcome to the fifth part of our discussion of sentence diagramming today in Shiksha Mantra. We have so far discussed about the subjects, the objects, the proposition, etc., etc. And today we are going to discuss a very important part that's also an integral part of our sentence formation, that's regarding adjective. Yes dear friends, today we'd learn how to make sentence diagramming for adjectives. That's a very important discussion, so stay tuned. Today we'll discuss everything about how we must place adjectives in our sentence diagramming. So let's begin. So here we are with our 21st rules for sentence diagramming, and it says adjectives. Yes dear friends, here we'll learn how to put adjectives in sentence diagram and where to put adjectives in sentence diagram. But first read the sentence. Athletic moves excite the crowd. Now if we consider this sentence, here athletic moves, this is the subject of this sentence, and then comes excite the verb, and then comes the crowd object. Okay, so we'd place them, and this is also direct object. We have to remember it, whether it's direct or indirect, because for direct object and indirect object we get two different sets of structures. So here we begin with moves, that's the noun for which an adjective athletic is used. So we have put the adjective like this, and together they form the subject of this sentence. So here we get the subject of this sentence, moves, which sorts of moves? Athletic moves. So finally we get the subject, athletic moves. We have placed the adjective with the noun, and now it's time for the verb, and then the direct object crowd, and there the article though. So finally we have caged, we have successfully framed moves excite crowd. For moves, adjective athletic, excite is the verb, and the crowd with article, the direct object, and finally we have framed it. This is how we have to use the adjectives. What's the most important factor here? What's the key factor? The key factor is you have to find out the antecedent noun. Here the antecedent noun is moves, and for the antecedent noun you are using an adjective, and you have to frame, you have to cage the adjective with its antecedent noun. That's the trick, that's the method, and also that's the logic for framing adjective sentences. So we have completed our first rules for the day, and the 21st for our average discussion. And here I would again tell you one thing very clearly, and what's that? If you have missed the other parts of this video, you have to go to the description box, and there I have put all the links. First check the previous discussion and then come here. It would be easier for you to understand it. So let's shift to our next rules, see what's waiting for the 22nd rules. So here we are with our 22nd rules of the discussion. And it says what? It says compound adjectives. Yes dear friends, now things are going to get a bit complicated, but it's not so complete if you follow the logic. I have repeatedly told you, just follow the logic and get everything very much easy. So let's read the sentence first, and then I'll show you how I'm using the logic and making things just simple. So here's the sentence. The little old lady hit the tall and distinguished gentleman. So whatever I have written in red are related to adjectives. So here you would find the two things. One verb, hit, and the other is gentleman. And otherwise there's another noun, lady. And the rest are adjectives and conjunctions. So how I have managed it? First, I have found out the subject of this sentence, and the subject of the sentence is the little old lady. Here lady, this is the noun, so I have put it here in the subject part for this sentence. And then With the lady, I have added the article, another adjective little and another adjective old. So the little old lady, I have completed it. Then comes the verb it, and then another noun, gentleman. Now this object would to be what? Yes, it would to be handled. So how would handle it? The tall and distinguished. So the, I have put the here, then tall, distinguished, and it's added with and. So the tall and distinguished gentleman, we have framed it just following the logic. This is the object part of the sentence, and it's also used as the direct object. So for direct object, we use gauging like this. And finally, we have put the object part with the adjectives and also with the conjunction, just following the method, very simple method of framing the skeleton of a sentence. So finally, we have handled very easily compound adjectives for the sentence. Isn't it easy? Okay, it's obviously easy. So let's shift to the next rules for this discussion. So friends, here comes our 23rd rules, that is predicate adjectives. So sometimes adjectives are used as predicate. Here you won't find any particular noun as it and its antecedent, that is attached to it. As you know, we have two different types of adjectives, and what are they? They are predicative adjectives and what's the other? Attributive adjectives. So here we get a predicative adjectives, it's not an attributive adjectives, that's why we call it predicate adjectives. So read the sentence. Hercules is mighty. Now if we consider this sentence, obviously for mighty you won't get any antecedent noun attached to it, at as was the case for the other two instances. So here what you get? Here you get the subject as the antecedent noun for this adjective. So here we can't put mighty under Hercules. What would do this? Would use this as a predicate. So we would use them following the rules for caging the indirect objects. So how it would be? Let's show me. Hercules is mighty, that's the sentence. Here Hercules is the subject, is, that's the verb, and mighty, this is the predicate adjective. So to show the predicate adjectives, you have to put a slash as we have done already for indirect objects, and you'd get the structure of the predicate objects. You'd get the structure for the sentences with predicate objects. So let's shift to the next rule. So here we are with our 24th rules, and it says, yes dear friends, it says compound predicate adjectives. So every time we discuss something, we get a compound form of this. It doesn't mean that in predicate part you'd get only one adjective. You might get several adjectives connected with conjunctions and but, etc, etc. So what would do this? We just use them in compound form as we have done for the others. So here's the sentence. Hercules is mighty and honest. And what you'd find? You'd find that here we have used two adjectives, mighty and honest. So how to put them? Just as we have done, subject Hercules, then verb is, then we are putting mighty and honest with conjunction and. You have already done this for the other compound forms. Here you'd have to follow the same rules, and there you must remember another thing. As its predicate adjective, we'd put a slash like this. Okay, for the other indirect objects and for the other complements, we were putting slash like this, but now here for predicate adjectives, we'd put the slash like this from left to right. So that's the rules with which you can successfully put predicate adjectives in compound forms in your sentence diagramming. Isn't it easy? So let's shift to the 25th rules for this discussion. So here we are in our 25th rules for this discussion. And what's the rules? The rules is regarding comparative adjectives. Yes, dear friends, if you look at the structure, you'd get confused. So don't look at the structure now. Just listen to me and look at the structure only when I'll tell you. Okay, so first, read the sentence. What is given there? Ronnie is considerably taller than his sister. So there's a comparison. Comparison between whom? Comparison between Ronnie and his sister. Don't consider is right now. We'll talk about it later. So the comparison is between Ronnie and his sister. There's the conjunction than. The verb for Ronnie is. Now considerably, this is an adverb. And it's related to the adjective, comparative adjective, taller. So that's the logic. And now we'd put all the logic together in the frame. Okay. So let's begin with the subject first. So the subject Ronnie, we have put it here. Then the verb is. So Ronnie is. We have handled one clause. Ronnie is. Ronnie is what? Ronnie is taller. So there comes the predicative adjectives. We have put a slash here. Ronnie is taller. How taller? Considerably taller. So the adverb is put just like we have done it with the adjectives. So the same way you'd have to put the description of the adjectives. That's the adverb. So considerably taller. So now we have completed Ronnie is considerably taller. Then comes the comparison than. So here we'd put a dotted lines and write down than. So finally we have reached so far, Ronnie is considerably taller than. Than whom? Then comes brother. Oh, sorry, it must be sister. I have written brother. Whatever it might be, just consider it as brother. So taller, brother. Whose brother? His brother. So Ronnie is considerably taller than his brother. Okay, we have reached to this far. So Ronnie is taller, considerably taller than brother, his brother. And then I have put a place for the verb and then I have put a cross. So what is this? Actually, when we say Ronnie is considerably taller than his brother, obviously there's is. That's why I have put the verb in the bracket. But in actual sentence, you won't get this. You would get the sentence till this part. You won't get this. So Ronnie is considerably taller than his brother. So we have completed the sentence, but there's a verb and this is understood. So to put the verb here as in understood form, we would put a cross in the verb position. So for this clause, than his sister, this is the subject and this is the verb. The verb remains understood. So that's how we have to handle comparative adjectives. Yes, dear friends, now you have to consider everything very keenly, very logically. Nothing would work but your logical framing. You have to be logical. You have to make everything considerable according to the rules of English grammar. That's why when you learn sentence diagramming, your knowledge of English grammar gets consolidated. So for the adjectives, for the discussion today in the part 5, we have these points up to 25. And then we'd learn the next in our part 6 video. So what's the most important factor here? Let's have a recap of all the important factors we have discussed here. So far we have learned that when we are framing sentences with adjectives, we must treat them for first time. It's like predicate. Okay. So when it's predicate, that is when it's predicative adjectives, you have to put it right after the verb. And its antecedent noun won't get directly connected to it. That's very important. And then when you get the other adjectives, you have to put them one after another in the sequence as it is in the sentence. In its at the bottom, one after another by putting a slash. and for the comparative adjectives, you have to be very much logical, otherwise you are going to miss something and obviously your sentence diagram might be problematic. Now, what's the key factor for sentence diagramming? You have to remember, you are diagramming a sentence from a key sentence. So when your diagram would be followed, that key sentence must get returned. So this is the most important factor. That's why you have to learn the logic used in the sentence. Otherwise, you can't get your sentence back. So this is the most important factor regarding our discussion of what? Of sentence diagramming. So we have completed the part 5 of this session, and tomorrow we'll meet with the part 6 of sentence diagramming. That's going to be very much interesting. So stay glued to this channel. If you like this new concept, obviously you have to do one thing, and that's what? That is to share it with your friends and family and relatives so that the others could learn this beautiful thing. And if you are a newcomer and you liked this, obviously you have the subscribe button to press and press the bell icon then to get the fresh notifications of all the videos. So we are returning very soon with the 6th part of sentence diagramming. Till then, happy learning.